Good afternoon. My name is Edwil Janssen. I'm the Regional Vice President for the Financial Services Industry at Salesforce in the Netherlands.
And my name is Raja Singh. I'm the Vice President and General Manager of Insurance at Velocity.
So many companies, if not all companies, are in the middle of a transformation. Some of them actually have a digital transformation office. And it's not easy to become really omnichannel. Many of the companies have a lot of legacy systems that sometimes do not really cooperate in your ideas to become digitally enabled. Since 1999, Salesforce has built a fully cloud-based integrated customer engagement platform, which provides solutions for marketing, sales, service, commerce, IoT, analytics, and other things. And next to that platform, which is now used by over 200,000 companies around the globe for all different industries, we also have created our own ecosystem, which we call our Ohana. And in one of those part of that ecosystem is our App Exchange. The App Exchange is a app store in which more than 3,500 independent software vendors build on top of our engagement platform specific solutions for specific problems, either industries or specific functional areas. One of the fastest growing partners of us is Velocity. Velocity has built a digital insurance platform on top of our customer engagement platform. And I'm happy to introduce to you Raja, who will present to you the latest features of the claims solution by Velocity.
Thank you, Edwell. And it's great to be back here at DIA to introduce yet another Velocity product, this time in digital claims experience. And I think we all know that the claim represents a key milestone in a customer journey. It's a moment of truth, if you will, not just from a financial perspective, but also from a customer experience perspective. A recent survey from Accenture found that customers actually expect the same level of digital capability and engagement on the claim side that they do when they're actually quoting a new policy or getting ongoing service. In fact, 44% of the respondents from that survey said that they would actually switch carriers if things like a claim status and a first notice of loss were not available online. And they identified factors such as the speed of claim settlement and the transparency of the process as some of the key satisfaction factors. So at Velocity, we've effectively built a new digital claims experience within Salesforce that provides deep claims functionality, but also does it in a very open way that provides carriers a path to integrate many of the AI and additional claims capabilities we've seen here today, but yet provide a common claims experience across line of businesses. So let me show you how it works. Let's go ahead and dive into the demo. And I'm going to start by taking a look at a policyholder portal. Now, these are Velocity's components running within a Salesforce community, and these can, of course, be completely white-labeled and rebranded to match the carrier or the broker's styles. In this case, we have a young millennial named Sophia Fournier who has a couple different policies with us. A car policy as well as a renter's policy. And unfortunately, Sophia has had a fire in her apartment and needs to make a claim against that renter's policy. So we're going to help her go ahead and do that. And so we can drill down and just take a look at the policy here. And this will include all the coverages and all the other data. Have to have a little bit of excitement in a live demo, now, don't we? And I can click here to file a claim to walk through the process. Now, first, an organizing principle on what we've done with Velocity. Everything we've done in the claim solution is what we call peril-driven. So depending on the type of loss the customer has experienced, whether it's been a fire, a flood, a robbery, or some other type of peril in the home, we completely change the rules that we run, the data we collect, the services we call, and the opportunities we offer to the customer. Now, in this case, we're going to click on fire, and you'll notice that the steps across the top are going to change. So we want to record some basic information about the loss. It's a grease fire in the kitchen. We'll say it's some really bad cooking that caused this fire, and it happened just recently, and it happened at the insured property. Now, once I go ahead and set that loss date and the type of peril, we're going to run our policy verification service and make sure that at that date and time, there was coverage, in fact, for that loss. Each of those perils that we define, we also associate back with the coverage as part of the policy to make sure that we know what was in effect at the time of the loss and can recall the relative terms. In this case, we see that Sophia has 100,000 euros worth of coverage with a deductible of just 500 euros, so we're going to go ahead and file the claim. We can identify a few factors, such as the type of claim and inter-a loss amount. Ask if she can still live in her home. We're going to say no. And ask about the intensity of, let's say, the odor. And we can also upload any different photos we have here from the site. And we'll pull a picture of the kitchen to upload. Not a good site for Sophia. Now, at this point, I'm just going to, for sake of time, expedite through. We can also ask about responsible parties, whether or not there's been any injuries, whether or not there were police or fire reports that were filed. And once I answer no to that last question, it actually runs through a series of our Velocity rules engines and makes a couple recommendations for Sophia. First of all, we offer that we're ready to help. Because we've identified that there is an odor in the apartment, we've offered to get our team out there to help remediate that immediately. And because she said she wasn't able to live in the apartment, we'd offer her access to our temporary housing team to find her a place to live in the interim. We've also run basically our auto adjudication rules. And unfortunately, because this claim falls above the limit that we pay automatically, it's going to refer this for a claim handler. Now, for sake of time in our demonstration here today, I'm going to actually switch over to a claim handler view. And one of the benefits that we have in working with our partners at Salesforce is that we can offer these solutions in multiple channels and actually closely embed the claim experience within the broader customer relationship management experience of the Salesforce cloud. So in this case, as a claim handler, I have access to basically all the information that was filed, including people like the any parties that were injured or potentially responsible, details as to the property that was damaged, in this case her apartment, as well as the ability to review any type of multimedia assets. In this case, they're fairly simple, like the image that I showed a moment ago. But these could also include videos, drone footage, other types of inserts running within this, this web container. And then once I've reached that point, I can see here that there's already been some next steps, like the odor remediation team has already been called on site. And I can navigate here, and as the adjuster, I can work through a series of transactions, including payments, recoveries, subrogations. And in this case, I'm going to set up the initial reserve at about 15,000. And this can basically post to our back-end financial systems, as well as it's recorded here within Salesforce and Velocity. And we can then process payments against that or recoveries against that into the future. So I think this concludes our demonstration. And please visit us in our living room area back in the main assembly hall.
Yeah. Okay, Raja, thanks. And I hope that everybody saw now this with this short demonstration also the strength of having this on an integrated platform. We saw already a number of fantastic solutions this morning. You will see another one this afternoon and tomorrow. And I want to invite all of these companies also to investigate whether they should be part of our Salesforce Exchange and part of our Ohana. So again, thanks for your attention, and we welcome all of you at our living room in the DL Lounge.